Yeah, I'll always be a metalhead. Nothing can take that away from me. Right. I mean, not jail, not people, not religion, not anything. I'll always be a metalhead. Metalhead.
You're listening to the Great Metal Debate Podcast.
Naglfar fans would be more than pleased with this highly anticipated and very long-awaited new album, Sirocloth. This band hasn't put out a record since Terez back in 2012. Naglfar has been my all-time favorite black metal band since the late 2000s, when I first discovered them in high school. For those of you who don't know, Naglfar is a melodic black metal band hailing all the way from Umeå, Sweden. Here is a fun and gross fact about the band's name. Naglfar, in Norse mythology, was a giant ship made entirely from finger and toenails of the dead. As soon as I heard a few months ago that new material would be released from this band through Century Media Records, I quickly put the hard copy CD on pre-order. Unfortunately, due to the current global pandemic, I didn't get the CD in the mail a week before the album's release date, so I had to listen through my Amazon Music app. The first song is the album title track, Sirocloth. One thing I noticed right away was how the guitar riff sounded very similar to the riff from the song A Swarm of Plagues from my personal favorite album, Pariah. Though the riffs sounded alike, any real Naglfar fan would tell you that the songs are completely different. This is a good thing because it shows their fans that they know how to keep the old sound in the new record. The next song, Horns, is a crushing and straightforward black metal song that makes the listener beg for more. It is also a song that lets first-time listeners get a real taste for Christopher Rath Olivia's raspy and hellish vocals. Like Poison for the Soul begins with a surprisingly groovy bass line performed by Alex Impaler before continuing to rape your ears with more ghoulish black metal. It's a work of art that warms you up for what the rest of the album has in store for you. For the fourth track, we have the song Vortex of Negativity. It starts off with the ominous sounds of a black electric guitar being quickly and consistently plucked to make an eerie tune. When the beat picks up after 10 seconds, we can visualize the simple yet beautifully shot music video for the song. Skipping ahead a couple of tracks, we come across a gem of a song called The Dagger in Creation. Musically, the most diverse song on this new record, it has its main riff and a common melody for a miniature guitar solo that really stands out before blasting you in the face with aggressiveness. The drummer, Ephraim Gentunian, who is also the drummer for the power metal band Persuader, is pretty much guaranteed to relentlessly kick your ass with his inhumanly fast double bass blast beat skills for the remainder of this album. Hats off to the guitarists, Andreas Nilsson and Marcus E. Norman, a.k.a. Varghor, for writing such a soothing intro for the song Necronaut and pretty much giving us nothing but noticeably great riffs throughout the entirety of your careers with Naglfar. With all of this praise I am giving to this band and all their musical accomplishments over the last 28 years, I can't not give this release anything less than a solid 9.5 out of 10. The only reason I don't give it a full 10 out of 10 is because it just still isn't as musically or lyrically catchy as their best 2005 album, Pariah. To me, this Sirocloth album is the band's equivalent to Sheol, Harvest, and Trios.